Join us now on the phone. Of course, we've just said that there are, well, the hospitals are at breaking point in terms of looking after those that were injured in clashes with the police. Can you just tell us exactly what's going on in the city?
Well, for the seventh day in a row, thousands of people are gathered here in Alexandria, in the heart of the capital, outside Al-Qaid Ibrahim Mosque, continuing their chants against President Mubarak and what they're calling half-hearted measures, half-hearted decisions aimed at placating their anger temporarily, but not addressing their problems, not addressing the root causes of why it is that they took to the streets in the first place. You had mentioned that the hospitals were overloaded with those injured in Alexandria, but it's not just that. There's a lot of anger here in Alexandria because of the large number of people who lost their lives in confrontations since the protests began. The last estimate we had heard unofficially from medical sources here in Alexandria is that more than 100 people in the city have lost their lives in the very violent confrontations, the rather violent confrontations that this city had witnessed for the past few days.
And of course, today was supposed to be a huge chance to show their anger and support for people in the capital, of course, for the million-man march. We think it's nearly reached 2 million in the capital. What sort of numbers are we talking about in Alexandria?
It is safe to say, Sohail, that hundreds of thousands of people are gathered now in Alexandria. It's very difficult, of course, to get a sense of the number just because of how spread out the protesters are. They began gathering at outside the Ibrahim Mosque, but now the protest is extending all the way, miles away, into Sidi Gebr neighborhood. Now, of course, Sidi Gebr is particularly symbolic, has particular significance because it was at that neighborhood that 28-year-old Khaled Said was beaten to death by police in June 2010. His brutal murder sparking nationwide anger, and it was from a Facebook page honoring his death that the calls for the day of anger, January 25th, first emerged from after activists were inspired by the uprising in Tunisia. This is a city that has been in turmoil for months, and people here simply cannot take half-hearted decisions, as they're telling us. They've seen their city almost torn apart by rising sectarian tension, culminating earlier this year on New Year's Eve in an attack outside a church here, killing more than 20 worshippers. This rising sectarian tension they had repeatedly blamed on the failure of the government to address the grievances of the Coptic community here. The more than one case of police brutality, at least three citizens of the city killed in the past 18 months on the hands of police. Unemployment, rising unemployment. In fact, one of the early cases of copycat self-immolations following the uprising in Tunisia was of a young man here in Alexandria who slit his wrists and set his body on fire. So just to give you a picture of how Alexandria, Egypt's second largest city, has come to symbolize pretty much everything that is wrong in Egypt, not to mention election violence that we've seen in November. This, of course, is a stronghold for the Muslim Brotherhood. The Muslim Brotherhood supporters here were involved in severe clashes with supporters of the government as they were trying to win any seat in the election in November, which many here contend were rather botched, and ultimately the Brotherhood failed to win any seats. So this gives you a picture of how on every level Alexandria has witnessed every single thing that was wrong with this country and why people here are simply not going to budge until they get what they want, and what they want is complete and utter change.
And of course, 2 months on, it's the 1st of February, and we have to ask really, you know, with what's going on right now, how many people can you sort of estimate had suggested that they may go from Alexandria and try and join those that are protesting in the capital? Is there any sort of indication?
There's no indication at this moment that people are trying to take their march. People of Alexandria are trying to take their march outside the city and march onto Cairo. They mainly want to hold their protest here on the grounds of the city, which, as I mentioned, has witnessed a lot, has been in turmoil in the past 18 months. So they actually want their Mediterranean city, their seafront city, to be portrayed as part of this nationalist day, as part of this in Cairo. iconic scenes that we're seeing here. They want their protests to continue marching by the iconic places here in Alexandria, the famous biblioteca, the famous port, the famous scenes of Alexandria. That's the message they want to relay at this moment. No indication that they're planning to join the protests in Cairo, mainly that railway traffic has been stopped between Alexandria and Cairo. The road is not particularly, the highway is not particularly safe, as we understand, for people to commute. So mainly a focus really on continuing their protests here, on continuing to try and portray iconic images, iconic scenes outside of this coastal Mediterranean city.
And of course, two new developments that have occurred really is the ongoing and increased vocal warnings from the international community, as well as the opposition now seeming to unify with one voice, relatively speaking. Is the message, or the messages that are coming from the international community and the opposition, actually getting to people in Alexandria? Do they know what the outside world is saying, and also what political opposition is saying within Egypt?
People here are very much aware of the size of the magnitude of what their uprising had achieved so far, but still, for a lot of people in Alexandria that we've spoken to feel that the international community is perhaps still not taking a strong enough stance to support them, to back them, to portray what is going on here. In fact, we are seeing an increasing number of signs in English. This is a new development just over the past 40 hours here in the protests in Alexandria. We're seeing an increasing number of signs and banners in the English language. Previously, most of the banners were in Arabic. Now we're seeing more of these English signs, and most of these signs have very strong words towards the Western governments, towards the foreign governments, towards the Western community, saying stop your hypocrisy, back the freedom of the Egyptian people. So certainly there is a sense that people are communicating, that people are able to listen and understand the efforts of the outside world, but clearly still a sentiment that whatever it is that's being said overseas is not enough, is not strong enough to back the will of the Egyptian people for real and genuine change.
And of course, one of the other issues that we're following across the day is the role of the military. We know that the military were on the streets. They couldn't protect the 11 districts within Alexandria because there's just a lack of personnel. But just give us a sense of the military's position in Alexandria and what they are able to do and how the people are reacting to them.
Well, we're seeing the military mainly parked outside the important strategic locations in Alexandria, the biblioteca, the famous biblioteca Alexandrina, the famous forts, the famous palaces, certainly the port, courthouses, other government buildings with important records, historic records, and day-to-day, really day-to-day paperwork type records that belong to the city. So more than an emphasis really on protecting these important institutions, these important buildings, but also just in the last 48 hours, we've seen a stepped-up role by the military, really strong checkpoints spread out around the city where the military is actually stopping people, stopping cars, searching cars, looking for identification cards, looking for weapons. Anyone with weapons is certainly stopped and questioned. We've seen the people, the residents of Alexandria, turn over a lot of what they're describing as suspicious individuals to the military, but the military does not seem to have any intention really at this moment to stop the protesters. We've seen iconic images, to say the least, of the military parading behind the protesters, really, where the military is waving the Egyptian flag. At one point, we've even seen the military overnight in one of those overnight marches fire, celebratory fire in the air, flares to light the night in Alexandria for the protesters, officers telling the protesters, we are firing flares in the air to honor and salute your your march. So certainly a strong sense of community, a strong sense of cooperation between the military and the people. The people here in their marches have repeatedly, we've heard them repeatedly chant, the army and the people are one hand, are hand in hand, a clear indication really of the friendly sentiment between the two sides. However, we're not seeing a stepped up presence perhaps in trying to chase after those who are involved in acts of looting or vandalism. It's more of the people really turning over these specific individuals to the military rather than the military chasing after these people.
Well, of course, we'll come back to you as the day progresses. Thank you for updating us from Alexandria. And these are live pictures from Tahrir Square in Egypt's capital, Cairo, of course.